all of 2015. In the meantime, let's quickly address some earnings. And Sunil Bhatia, who's CEO and MD at Blue Star Infotech, joins in to assess their numbers. And it seems like a good quarter because PAT has gone up, 50% almost. There's been a decent EBITDA margin performance. Revenues have gone up 6.5% as well. Come to you, Sunil. Good afternoon. Even though it's a small base, you've shown an improvement in earnings. Is this sustainable? Is this likely to be the run rate? Because, this is one quarter. Are we likely to see an encore from the following quarters as well?
Good afternoon to you. Yes, no, absolutely. You know, this is a result of the three strategies you've been following, for being a more solution provider, focusing on few areas that we know best, focusing on digital transformation and focusing on, trying to listen to what our customers say. So, yeah, I think these margins are sustainable for us going forward. From a revenue growth perspective as well, we think, the growth will certainly be sustainable from where we are.
That you will keep on growing at about 50% on a sequential basis? I mean, right now it's a low base, so the optical number looks
big. Certainly not. No, I thought Tanveer asked me, are the margin percentage basis fine? I don't think it'll be foolish for me to say we'll have 50% growth on the margins every year. I meant the percentage of revenue on the EBITDA percentage and the PAT percentage, which is at this point over 10%. And we think that is sustainable for us in the future going forward.
Okay, so
there has been a fundamental shift in Blue Star. Sorry, Tanveer, go ahead.
No, we were just asking. So then what kind of a sustainable growth rate on a CAGR basis are you kind of penciling in right now, the bottom line? Because that's what investors would be keen to understand.
I think the bottom line perspective will probably grow at, between 10 and 15% from where we are on a growth basis, because it's going to be both a dollar growth as well as a percentage growth. So when you look at from that perspective, that's going to be a fairly healthy margin basis to have.
To clear the air, 10 to 15% in constant currency or in dollar terms?
It'll be in dollar terms.
It'll be in dollar terms, okay.
We don't know where the dollar will go, but, go ahead.
If I break your revenue, 45% right now is domestic, 55% is overseas. When I talk to some industry leaders, they are of the view that the Indian economy or the Indian market is a soft market. Indian market accounts for nearly 45% of your business. What is your experience?
So, our revenue actually is going to be largely U.S. focused, and U.S. is going to be a more of the growth perspective that we'll see. Even in the India business that you see is largely on the large captives, the customers that we have internationally. Those are the customers we are servicing in India as well. So we think that on a India story per se, I think, from where we are perspective, we think the U.S. and some of the other developed market is probably a more focus area for us where we are.
Could you highlight how contracts are shaping up right now? Could you give us more details on that? You recently signed a $15 million contract spread over 3 years with an existing customer. How would the trajectory pan out for fresh orders as also ramp-ups on existing ones?
So I think, on an organic growth basis, I think we'll clearly see one and a half times to where the industry is going. And industry is going at about 12 or 15%. And we should probably grow at least at that level or if not higher from an organic perspective. Clearly from an acquisition perspective, we'll have to wait and see, what plays out. But I think on a top line perspective, on a net new basis that you're asking, then we'll continue to see that growth. I think that's what's happening in the industry as well. These are very, very interesting times for us in the industry.
Okay. Sunil, appreciate your time, Sunil, and good luck. Thank you for joining us.
Sure. Thank you so much. Absolutely. Have a great day, guys. Bye.
58 crore before minority interest. This is the PAT, what PVR has reported.